Hi, so this is Ed Gastle, product manager for the OLTS-85, and I'm going to give a very brief overview of the loss application that is available on the OLTS-85. The OLTS-85 home screen that you can see here has the different applications available. So there's a loss length application, there's a loss application that we'll focus on, it's a power meter, so a standalone optical power meter, standalone optical source, and then the digital inspection probe, which you get when you plug the P5000i into the instrument. If you look at the top of the instrument, you will see that there are three ports there. There is the single mode port that I'm plugged into, there's a multi-mode source port, and then there's the shared optical power meter that is an interchangeable, and right now I have an LC adapter on there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the loss application, and from the main screen of the loss application, it's quite simple. You can select your different wavelengths that you want to transmit on. So either the single mode wavelengths of 1310 and 1550, and you can turn those on and off independently. If you turn off everything, you'll notice that I have now grayed out my source icon here. These icons at the top are pointing you to what port that you're using. If I turn on the 850, the multi-mode, it's going to point to that second port. But I'm really interested in doing a single mode application, and I want to do that at both 1310 and 1550. I could choose to do that just at one of these wavelengths. And then it's really a simple case of turning the light source on, and you will start to be transmitting power. However, this application is really meant so that you are in a loopback mode. And a loopback mode means that you're going to have connecting from your light source to your power meter. And as an example, going up a tower, hitting a loopback, and then coming back down the tower and measuring that total loss both up and down. That's what the loss application is meant to do. There's no length measurement within there. If you press the menu button, which is the little right in the bottom of the screen, there's a little semicircle with an arrow up. You can press that, or on the instrument itself, you can press the key that gives you the kind of four lines there, and that will bring up the menu. And under that menu, you have a choice between being in pass-fail mode or being in dB mode, which is just going to show you dB values. There's also the wavelength selection button and the laser on, which you don't really need because you can control those directly by tapping the screen. But if I press the more button, the more does give me my ability to edit my reference and limit data. If I enter into that, I can see that I have set up my limits for 3 dB of loss at 1310 and at 1550. If I wanted to change that, I would simply tap on the 1310 as an example, press the menu button, and I can edit the limit, and I could change that to be 3.5 dB again as an example. I change that, and there it is. So I can now have one limit for 1310 and a different limit for 1550 if I want to do that. I press the back button, which returns me back to the previous screen. I can push that one more time, and I'll be back to the home screen. I'm going to go into the menu one more time, and there's a referencing button there. And if I press that, you'll notice that it tells me that it's not possible, that the laser is off. So you have to turn the laser on before you're able to do the reference. And the other thing that you really need to do is connect your source to your power meter. In this case, I've got a single fiber. You can see I've got the probe plugged in. I've already inspected this fiber. I'm not going to show that here in this quick demo. I'm now connecting my light source to my power meter. So I'll get my camera, my video a little bit better. And you can see I've just got my source connected to my power meter. I then turn on my laser. I then press my menu button, and I do a reference. And when I press that, it's going to say referencing active port at all wavelengths. It just takes a second, and it comes back, and you'll see that everything is at 0 dB. I am currently in the dB mode, so again, if I press the button, I've got dB and I've got pass-fail. If I go to pass-fail mode, now it's going to show me not the values, but it's going to show me whether it passed or failed based on those limits that I had set. So I can toggle back and forth on that if I want to. I'm going to go back to the dB mode. So now what I've got is I've got a little bit of a fiber here that I'm going to test. I unplug from my receive port. I unplug my LC from my receive port. I'm going to plug that into my system under test. I've already inspected these and cleaned them. I plug into that in my adapter. I then plug the other end of whatever it is I'm trying to test. I'm going to uncap that. I will clean this, although the receiver of the instrument is non-contact, so it's not as critical. You're not going to damage anything. You can affect your loss measurement. And I'm going to plug that in. And so you can see I've got 0.2 dB of loss. I'm just testing a short little link here. And if I wanted to, I could then change that to pass-fail, which will pass. Remember, I had set those up to be 3 dB and 3.5 dB, so obviously 0.2 dB is going to pass. And again, that just shows me my values. If I want to toggle back and forth, I hit the menu, I go to dB, and there I go. Now, the last thing that I can do if I want to is I can save the result. I hit the save button on the instrument. It says it's fiber ID number 1, and I can just hit save again, and that is then saved. And I can use something like Smart Reporter in order to generate a test report for this if need be. Most time, people that are using the loss application don't necessarily need to save results, but if you do need to save results, you can do it that way. And that's it. Quick little demo of how the loss application works on the OLTS-85.